Hi, I'm Mike Bosberg, the Biology Education Manager at PASCO Scientific. And today we're going to be looking at the wireless CO2 sensor. Let's go ahead and see what's in the box. We've got an instruction sheet, a USB cable, 250 milliliter sample bottle for common experiments, and the sensor itself. Let's go ahead and connect the sensor. I'll power it on. The sensor comes pre-charged, but you may want to top it off if you're going to perform a long experiment. In logging mode, the sensor can run for up to 14 hours continuously, so you shouldn't have any problems getting through a full day of labs. Notice that the Bluetooth LED is blinking red, indicating that it's ready to pair. I'll launch SparkView and open the Bluetooth menu. My sensor should be at the top of the list. We can also match the 6-digit ID number found on the sensor. I'll select that sensor to connect. Once it's connected, you'll see it move into connected devices within the software, and the Bluetooth LED is now blinking green, indicating that it's paired. I'll click Done to close the menu. And on the home screen, we'll see CO2 concentration. For outdoor measurements, you should expect the initial values to be around 400 parts per million, plus or minus 100. Indoors, the values may be as high as 1,000. To get started, I'll click CO2, which will build the basic data displays, a graph, digits, table, and a meter. To do a quick introductory demo, I'll begin data collection and simply exhale into the sample bottle. The sensor can go up to 100,000 ppm or 10% CO2 concentrations, which is more than high enough to measure respiration of humans. I'll insert the sensor and wait about a minute for it to equilibrate. For most people, we'll expect the final CO2 concentration to be around 30 to 45,000 parts per million. If you'd like more information on this or other wireless products, please visit pasco.com/wireless. Thanks for watching and see you next time.